amici sciuntechi iniziata a ci giota a te che a giota a cucci tone ci c'è in ordine a ne tanto a ne su ma cucci vedi a ciume di lui più non ciume di ne tanto a ne su di ne le ci c'è a giro e mi ha raggiù ci vedi.
Now I only use valid and authentic Chinese documents that are acceptable to the People's Republic of China. And it follows all these criteria. So all the evidence and documents that are used, number one, they have to be written in the Chinese language by Chinese. They were published in China between 1279, which is Yuan Dynasty, to the beginning of the PRC, which is 1949. Most of these documents have then been republished and reprinted by the People's Republic of China after 1949. They are also available for examination using websites that are operated by a firm by the People's Republic of China. In other words, I'm using only evidence that are accepted and considered as valid by the People's Republic of China. In short, what I'm saying is that don't believe in a single word I say, go and check it out yourself. And of course, I'm addressing this not particularly to the press, it's actually more to my Chinese friends, is that if you don't believe it, check it out. And so, but today, of course, because of the time limitation, I can only cover a few of the things that I've done. So the first thing is that I'm going through some very, very brief introduction to Chinese history documents. And then after that, I'm going to just look at the Ming Dynasty evidence. And then I'm going to look at just some of the Qing, if we have time, which I don't very much. But then the secondary objective is really to then demonstrate to you how the PRC has falsified and destroyed Chinese historical records. I think there are two messages. One, of course, is that Tibet was never part of China. But the other message I want to really bring across for people who want to listen to what I have to say is that there are really two kinds of history. PRC history and Chinese history. They are very, okay? PRC history, a bunch of lies. The Chinese history is really very reliable if you look at the Chinese documentary records.
Anything?
Okay, so this is a very brief introduction of Chinese historical documents that are considered to be authoritative, accepted to be as authoritative by all Chinese. Okay, first of all, there's such a thing as the Si Ku Qian Shu, which is a comprehensive four libraries, and this is actually a set of books. They are altogether actually about 3,400 of those. There have been written over the past 3,000, 4,000 years that have been collected by the Qianlong Emperor and then republished as a set. In other words, those things are authenticated, they are accepted as the best and most reliable sources of information of Chinese culture. And of course, the Si Ku, the four libraries, means that the scriptures, histories, writings of sages and collected works of major scholars, and four of those, and of course we are interested primarily, of course, in the history part. And the history part, of course, you have to understand, you know, the system that goes back thousands of years, and how Chinese history are recorded. First of all, for many centuries, they have such a thing as called the rising and living records. And literally what happens is that somebody will follow the emperor. After the emperor rises from the bed, there will be somebody follow the emperor, recording everything. And that is done like a daily diary for each emperor. And that's called the daily records. After the death of each emperor, then the succeeding emperor, usually the son or whatever, will appoint an editorial board consisting of a good number of outstanding scholars, and will then compile what's called the veritable records, okay, of the emperor. In other words, this is the daily records, and the whole bunch of daily records of the entire life of this emperor will be compiled into veritable records. And then, of course, there are other primary sources, okay, and there's submission from officials, okay, and then there are also imperial edicts from the emperor. So these are what we call primary sources of records. And again, as I've said, they are very reliable. It follows a tradition of thousands of years of keeping these records.
Mm-hmm. 아깝네 니레기 아니 체조 체고 상마시 마 토크베기 룩스조레 야 아디 아니야 고마 디야 디 샤베젤 아니야 디기 제기 고메디기 아니야 딩에 고메기 루규 참마마야 티제 데레치 티스조레 디간라 아니야 레제이네 데딘데기야 고제소기야 토크웨시 직체 아니야 셴바치냐 아야 공만에 마 까제탕스 샤웨기 미쳤는데 망고치클라 시샤기로스.
And these veritable records for each emperor, then for all the emperors of a dynasty, they will be then collected again, and they will then be used to compile what is called the official history of the preceding dynasty. And yeah, go ahead. And these are what's called the correct or official history that are accepted by all the Chinese. They're all together 24 or 25, depending on how you count them. The 24 sort of sets of official histories, and of course for the purpose of today's discussion, we're only interested in these two dynasties, Ming Dynasty and Qing Dynasty. The author of the Qing Dynasty history is particularly interesting because the chief editor of that book is Zhao Xin, and many of you probably know his brother, Zhao Feng, which is otherwise known as the Butcher of Tibet.
Any
All these books, okay, the histories and then these records or whatever, they form this large set of documents that are called imperially commissioned documents. They are specifically commissioned by the emperors of various years. Okay, they are considered as, of course, the most authoritative records and reliable records of Chinese history.
Donzo, any Goma Ran, any Ma Kushawa, any Kayatame Tone, any Duru Cheshawa Indu, and Donzo Kunde, Tisayores.
So this is just how you can get all those information from the internet for free of charge. They are open for inspection. I think I'll just skip the details. So anyway, I have just finished talking about a brief introduction of what constitutes reliable Chinese historical records. Okay, so we are down to the second topic, and that is we want to see whether Tibet was independent of China during the Ming Dynasty by looking at how the Chinese classify foreign versus internal regions in the geographical publications. So we are over here.
Great. 他的公共的那些工作是什么吵架了？像是实验有的是，那你的啊，我这边的你像是他的学校啊，因此，那谈到那个啊，带的谈到民的公民的搞呢，那你别的革命工人民被的啊，空阶段的看待的学位呢，不然是你一家看那落了，那你家设定开始自己有的，那你家买一百的七六七七零十年的这里开始自己有的设定了。 아니 야 풍을 가르 쓰고 요래 야이 풍을 가르 쓰고 요 말에 어디 짓다고 해 계신 분
Okay, so we're going to look at three versions. One is a PRC's version, and then we're going to look at the Qing government's version, and then we're going to look at the Ming government's version of how Tibet was considered during the Ming dynasty. So first of all, let's look at the PRC's version. The most authoritative statement by the PRC is this publication is called the Historical Atlas of China. And you will look at, for example, the Wikipedia. In China, of course, they block Wikipedia. It's not sort of universally available. But the Chinese government in mainland China, they provide an alternative, which is called Baidu. So most of the people get the background information from Baidu. The idea, of course, of my research is to use as much as possible PLC's information and PLC's background. Okay? So in other words, we are trying to use their own information so that they cannot deny you know, what they're saying. So over here, this is what Baidu says, okay? And that basically what it says is that this set of atlas, of maps, okay, is the most authoritative statement that conforms with the official views of the People's Republic of China. And the chief editor, of course, is the one of the leading, if not the leading, scholars in historic geography of China. And that the atlas itself is, of course, one of the most important achievements in the field of history of China since
1949. 你当，你控制于他的那个有没得，另外一边，明当，你清单，人家给购买，搞不你他的那个有没得这些，你说你多少钱，你开挖开的多大些，俺他个能行，俺你，江南南路了，谷歌搜了，人家给买的地基，俺你啊啊，几块多的百度写的，下个月的地南路了，控制给他的那个有没得，他那个啥子，给你个啥子，别啊，人家突破人家业绩有问题，俺你。
So this is the statement of the PRC. You can see that their interpretation of Ming Dynasty, okay, according to the current PRC's government, during Ming Dynasty, the white part that's outside China, everything that's colored is part of China. But they recognize that during the Ming Dynasty, Mongolia and Xinjiang, they are China, but they were not part of the Ming Empire. In contrast, they specifically and explicitly state that Manchuria, as you can see, is yellow. Yellow is part of Ming Empire, and also Tibet is part of the Ming Empire. So this is what the Chinese are taught since the Yang Age, and that is Manchuria and Tibet, they were part of the Ming Empire. But these two areas, they were not part of Ming Empire, even though they're part of China. For those of you who know a little bit about China history, one of the most interesting conclusions out of this is that somebody by the name of Wu Sangui, which is widely believed by people like us as the arch traitor of China, right now becomes a national hero, because if Manchuria at that time was part of the Ming Empire, then that would mean that Manchuria didn't invade China, it was just a unification. That this Wu Sangui was actually a hero that allowed the Manchurians to come and conquer China. But anyway, Tibet is very clearly part of China according to the statement of the PRC.
And the government, any those such a cow, so cow you do the any the main chiro libache, any tanda the yahoo membership, any tuition buttonzo, tanda the penetration of her the main di, kung libache chuyo, and Taramanshi Mongolia, the Xinjiang donzo, a main di, gome, kung, matsiwa, and those, and Taramanshi any Yemilu Gunalo, la Vichi, Kunzu, the any Chilone, Nurking Agency, the under the Manchuria, the any under the Mingi, the Borubi, the any Atapas, the Yoma, the ship.
Incidentally, the People's Republic of China doesn't give the source or the authoritative background of this sort of interpretation of the territorial rights. They simply said, well, that's what I say, but what are your proofs? And then it's considered as, well, unimportant, obviously.
Any plans to learn any subject to the motto, any kung kari yime, any the day came out, check, do change any plans to learn this.
Okay, let's look at other versions. So this is the version by Ming History. I've just explained that in China we have such a thing as called the official correct history. We have 24, 25 sets of these histories. It goes back to thousands of years. And Ming History, of course, if you look at Baidu again, you can see what they say about Ming History. It's well recognized, actually, as it's the authoritative work on Ming history. Okay, and so maybe you don't have to translate the whole thing. Just mention that this is recognized as the authoritative work.
And the Ming Yara Blue any bad tundendo singi yores.
Yeah. And of course this is from Baidu again, it's from the Chinese version of Wikipedia. So again, this is just an example of how you can get the whole book, okay, from the internet for free. And this is a source, we don't have to go into details today. And so anyway, I'm gonna skip all those. Those are just images from the tables of content. I'm just gonna skip all those and look at the actual summary. This is the structure of Ming history, the table of contents. We have no time, of course, to look at the contents itself, but this is the table of contents. It's here. Now, this is following a 2,000-year-old tradition, is that each dynasty, when you have the official history that's written by the government, it follows this structure. The beginning of the book, there will be an annals of main events, followed by astronomic and meteorological and other natural events, such as earthquakes or whatever. And then after that, in the front part of the book, it'll be the geography section. In the case of Ming history, you have geography 1 to geography 7, where every territorial piece of land is recorded. And in the Ming history, geography 1 to geography 7, these explicit places are listed as provinces, Shandong, Shanxi, blah, 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 and so forth, okay? It's interesting to note, I'll be a little bit long, but you can look at that and translate, right? Okay. If you look at the Yunnan province section in Geography 7, they explicitly say that Burma, which is today's Myanmar, Laos, and today's Northern Thailand, they're part of Yunnan's province. In other words, the Chinese are not shy in claiming, you know, what they consider to be theirs, but there's, of course, no mention of any Tibetan region.
Any tanda mingi tanda di yara bruju di kunde di namlola ta yongdu di bet ko drom di e na ngamone lo nidong has gi any naso gi any nangshin shi ma dus drom di ma ta yongdu any tango konzo gi nezu chi a dusu ku shemba any a chungwe gi nezu shemba in de ku ene any ke chi a di any konzo gi yara pranzo gi lumba gi a ka pranzan gi Omegi and Sata Dinamola, any Karikari Tsuyu, Mechazan, Chikuyores, any Dinamola Tana, Burma, the Laos, the Chang, Thailand, the Saja and the France of the Tanta Kuyores, Sudu, Konsogi, to do Konsogi Tia, Inez, Jimba, and Konsogi Tia, the Peso Yomare, to do Puran Yon Jongi, the Bula, Podina Kuyo Yomares.
And then after that, there are other things that are important to China. structure of officialdom, economy and taxation, all kinds of things that's related to the national economy, the political system, the official system, and so forth. And then you have the imperial families. So these are the things that are given at a, remember, the whole book has 332 volumes, and out of that, the first 309 volumes, of course, are devoted to things that are considered as more important to China. And Tibet is never mentioned in any of these places. And then, of course, after that, in the towards the sort of the end of the book, okay, they have ethnic rulers, okay, and the ethnic rulers are in various provinces. And again, this in this section, it's mentioned once more that you have ethnic rulers that belong to China, and they are now in today's Burma, Myanmar, Laos, and northern Thailand. Again, Tibet is not mentioned here at all. Now after that, it comes places that are outside China, okay, which are considered, of course, of much less importance to the Chinese. But then they list the foreign countries that have a relationship with China, and they list about 70 plus countries, and in the order of appearance, it will be Korea, Vietnam, Japan, and then later on, it includes also some European countries, such as Holland and Italy.
Chige lumba mangbo chila ani jawa yume ge ani jende lumba dunju has chi thona kyo yo re donso lumba mangbo chi am yage kyo wa lumba mangbo chi ani thana nucho ge ga bende di bol kyo yo re.
And then in the last four sections or last four volumes, okay, of the 332 volume piece of work, they have Western lands, and Western land is a traditional standard term used in Chinese language to mean everything that is west of China all the way to the Roman Empire. The term was actually first used during the Han Dynasty, which is like, you know, 100 BC and so forth, when the Roman Empire first started sending envoys to China. And then this whole area, Western, simply means anything that's west of China. And then among these Western lands, sorry, And then in Western land number three, okay, which is the second to last volume, then Tibet is mentioned, and it's here. So in scroll number 331, which is second to last scroll, these places are listed, and among them are the religious kings and the spiritual kings in Tibet. And also there's then after that, there is this place, which all Chinese scholars now agree that they have no idea where this place is. It's probably a fake nation. The envoys came and so-called submitted tributes and got a lot of gifts from the emperor and just left, okay, never be seen again. And then after that, there's Nepal. And then after that, this is the primary, really, the claim of sovereignty by the PRC, because the PRC claims that the Ming Dynasty has appointed officers, ruling officers, which with the title of officer, office of the commander in Tibet, okay? And so what they're saying is that, well, I see we have appointed somebody there, without really ever telling that, yeah, people that, yeah, that officer, you know, comes in this place, okay? But anyway.
Any nuchok gega leje, any lumo mangush digo su de wore, any han gigome cup ne, any nuchok gega su de tape, yanagi nubla yoa ya tanda rom patue su de agi dendegi, and lumo mangush digo suore, and donzo pula, donzo gichige lumba zigo nango ne, pedi a chick chagi ore, any tender you do any pergi quality she.
So So, and then of course, this is the second to last volume. The last volume would include places like Samarkand, which is in today's Central Asia, and Medina and Mecca, which is in today's Saudi Arabia. Okay, we have just seen one official document by the Qing dynasty. Remember, I said that every dynasty, the history is written by the succeeding dynasty. So the Ming history was actually compiled by scholars during the succeeding dynasty, which is Qing dynasty. So the question that you might ask is that, well, maybe the Qing dynasty scholars, you're just trying to belittle the predecessor, okay? In other words, you might say that, well, Tibet was actually part of the Ming Empire, but somehow the Qing people just refused to recognize it. So let's look at the Ming dynasty publication. Now, this is another example of what you call an imperially commissioned publication. So actually, this is another tradition in China, and it's every dynasty since the Tang dynasty, which is back in about 600 AD. Every dynasty, they prepare a detailed compilation of all the territories under the rule. And so you have the Tang record, you have the Song record, and then the Yuan, and then now, of course, Ming, it's called the Great Ming Unification Record. The word unification is worth noticing because it does mean that they stress that we have unified our country and this is all our territories, okay? I don't think I want to go into this, but what it roughly means is that these records not only are commissioned by the emperor, then they are compiled by scholars, leading scholars, they're appointed by the government, and then they are revised several times over a dynasty of 250 to 300 years because territorial limits, territorial boundaries do change over the 200 plus years of, let's say, the Ming dynasty.
Ani oma deri ge jela ti ge jegi ani ya thanda Ming ge jela Qing le yo na ani Ming ge ji ome ge tsu di da ani France ge kai kan chung me di ge ro ge cha sa di Qing ge ani ome ge ka ma ya su du che je ani cha ge u ji ku ge yo res ani ta de lo so za ta do zo Tawas Tishal Mebache, Mambu Chiki, Duru Chevig Tone, and Yak Kasu Chevers, and Ponzo Kanda Shinju Mambu Chen, any Tishal Yoshibes.
So, this is the structure of the, again, we can't look at the table of content, of course, because there are 5,600 pages, okay, there are 5,600 pages, and again, this whole book can be downloaded from the internet for free from PLC websites. In other words, that there's no possibility of faking it, okay? The PLC accepts it as the authority. They're all together 90 volumes or 90 scrolls. And out of 90 scrolls, again, just by using common sense that everybody would do, and that is the important thing comes first. So to the Chinese, during the Ming Dynasty, their own country comes first, okay? They have a record of all these sort of the different areas. So they have the national capital cities, and then by volume 32, they have Shanxi, and then after they have Yunnan, and again, in Yunnan, they mention very clearly that they have Burma, Myanmar, they have northern Thailand, and then they have Laos as part of the districts under the Yunnan Provisional Administration. And then, as you can see, out of the 90 volumes, in the last two volumes, okay, these foreign countries, of course, are relegated to the last two volumes because it's of less importance than a part of China. And in fact, they are explicitly labeled as foreign aliens or foreign foreigners. You can't be more foreign than a foreign foreigner, okay? And it's specifically said, these are foreign foreigners, and they are listed as follows. The first one is Korea, the second one is Manchuria, the third one is Japan, the fourth one is Okinawa, Rukyu, and the fifth one, this of course, this term, okay, the standard term for Tibet in Chinese, so Tibet is listed, okay, as the fifth of these foreign countries of foreign aliens. After that, then of course, you have more foreign countries like Vietnam, and then eventually you have Mecca and Medina, which is in Saudi Arabia. Altogether, 57 foreign countries are listed, out of which, again, as I've said, Tibet is listed as the fifth one of these foreign countries.
And Gang de la France, Yami Rangi, any Nabo in the Nezu di Che, any Tep, Gejuke, Wukchudon Zunalola, any Chilogi, Chige, Gopki, Toma, Kurje, any Korea, Manchuria, then Japan, any Donsche, any Purdy, Tanga, Shiwanga, the Yoche, any Taran, Shi Lumba, Shilo, Chi Lumba, Mampushna, Vietnam, any Mampushma, Kurio, to Kern Dombe, Chige, Gopnapchung of Du Konsogi.
Okay, I'm going to skip all those. These are supposed to, you know, show you the images, but you don't have time to go through this. Incidentally, the book comes with this preface that's written by the emperor. The emperor writes a preface for this, and this is a brief. Sort of translation of the preface. I'll just pick out some sentences. They say very explicitly over here is that our Ming Empire, the westward, reaches the sand dunes, which is now Gansu and Xinjiang. In other words, now this is the current PRC map, okay? So the sand dunes is here. In other words, the Ming Emperor, in his preface, says very clearly is that our westward boundary is about here, okay? This is today's Tibet Autonomous Region. So, okay, that's what he says. Also, it says that, lands in all directions, the entire world, without exception, come to accord and pay the respect. It's just standard braggery. Okay? I mean, the Chinese emperor, most emperors probably say that, you know, we rule the world. But then it then says, as for governing within our national boundaries, in other words, let's be serious, okay? Let's talk about the real thing. They say, well, as far as the real thing is concerned, governing within our national boundaries, they are the capital cities, and the world under us, which is the world that's relevant to China, is divided into 13 provinces, and then blah, 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 and so forth. The end. You know, it's, you know, that it is. Again, that is it. Tibet, of course, again, is not mentioned. And after that, they also do indicate that also recorded aliens from all directions to which we confer official titles. And of course, it's well known that they confer titles to the Tibetan people. That's no sort of dispute over that. But that's, these are the aliens, and not just the Tibetans. Actually, they claim that they have conferred titles to the French in Europe, by the way. Okay? And a whole bunch of other people.
Any tapi na lo ni kechi a chi godela, any wenju cheju soroji yores di kana gi goma rangi a di shawa chi kres. And na station se o kar kuyo sana, he kana gi any nub gi sanzam gi tadi kawa la zogu yume di station se o kuyo be di ma tik di ma he yongdu any kuyo di halam di kuno chagi mewa chi. Taka nang shi any
The book also contains a map at the beginning of the book. Remember, this is a book that has 5,600 pages. Okay, in the beginning, it says over here, map of unification of the Great Ming Empire. Okay? And so that's a map that everybody has a copy in front of you. So if you can't see it clearly, you can see it, you know, on this sheet over here. Everybody has one?
Yes.
Okay. If you look at that, what you see is that, and this, of course, remember, is prepared by the Ming government in 1461. These are the Chinese regions, okay? This means the capital city, and this means Shanxi province, and this means the Fujian province. You can see that all these Chinese areas, they are framed. And then there's a black background, and on top of it, you can see the white lettering. So it's white lettering and black background, and it's framed. Okay? And then you can see that this is Manchuria, this is Korea, this is Japan, and this is Okinawa, and then this is the Western region. And it contrasts with the Chinese regions by three factors. It's not framed, it's white background, with black lettering. Everybody sees that? And this, of course, is Tibet. And so Tibet is, of course, you know, the same thing, non-framed. In other words, the contrast is literally in black and white. These are foreign areas, and these are Chinese areas.
아니 단다 캔즈 창막이 시디에 이 사프터들로 시워이나 아니 아 산점기 티기어와 직체 니와디 캐나 랑이 나콩라 유데와 돈조페 아 세오페 아 나자 나쿠나로로 투시 투시 유데와 돈조 아니 아 야미기 캐나 랑이 나콩라 돈조기 지데와 돈조체 아니 투시나 메와체 이니 이기 소타 유데 요디 메나 자반다 망고치 베트남다 푀 돈조 투시나 마춘 요디 아니 아 Peseo, kama mengshingi, ani, yodi, jahong meba seo des.
In other words, whether Tibet was part of the Ming Empire was actually a non-issue. In other words, the Ming Empire never actually claimed that Tibet was part of the Ming Empire. It was the PRC that comes up with this, with whatever claim you call it. So.
Tandati, yodi, Yami nga hong mingi gong me gap neri re ma re se di zuishi ke yo ma re se di Yama ne se upe ma yinba zi re pe Yine ta di sardu ane yami gi ma sho shungi ane Tudu ne re se ya gi ane zuyin do zi Sawa ni zi di nyewe tu la Go tsu sha gyo zi re ma to Gerab lu gyu na la Pe di mingi gong me gi nga hong Ne me ba di zuishi ke ne me wa zi re se
Now, again, to give you an example of what constitutes believable, valid evidence. You know, I mean, a lot of things can be fabricated. You know, I joke to my friends, I think, I always wear name brand shirts, okay? I get this name brand shirt from China at $5 a piece. You know, it's, you know, you can fabricate anything. You can get a Rolex watch for $100 in China, okay? You look at all these photographs, you look at all these things, okay? Anything can be fabricated. But these records cannot be fabricated. So, you have this, which is the Ming map, okay, that was published in 1461. I mentioned earlier that over the 280 year of rule of the Ming dynasty, they have actually edited and republished this and revised this several times because it's a state borders change. So this is one that was published in 16,000 in sort of a revised edition, and I purposely obtained it from the website that is provided by the Bavarian, which is Germany, okay, the Bavarian National Library, the East Asian Digital Collection. The idea is to show you that things like that, they are available not only from the Chinese websites, they're available in libraries in Columbia University, in Hong Kong, and of course in Germany, as you can see, okay, so you can't just make it up. And you can see that in this German edition, in this German website, you can see that the later version, okay, the map basically says the same thing, and it's over 150 years. Well, Tibet is still sort of not part of China.
But yijia dongzi de gang pei yong du, ta kari zuma re, kari mone re, se ya genja di lep yong du, ta tuklo soro, ta chuzo soro, ta ente ina zuma ente, su tu re. Yine dente ki yijia nyingba ente, kongde ente, zuma su tu re, mewa ji pe se u re. Ka tena cha shana, tanda Kuzhengene mingi gome kapne, any long mambu ring la kuzhengi, shimchu, shuda, chene, any kumde, chatumati, any handa de sata yuadi, chuchitong, shibja, chuchu, rechikla yuadi, transu chali yuadi, in a Germany, any the ravegi, any sata, chilo, chikong, tuga yuene, ravegi, sata die, te yundu, any dinuengaji, sata di da, di doriundu, chipa doji chagi or a kajansena. Di kongdei gyalab lukyu gi yikja donzo gyana tsamla ma yikwa chi gyaga mambu chile donzo rinbege ni ra deya da ndeji lukyu yore.
So we can actually go back to the PLC's version. I have shown this slide to just remind you how reliable the PLC version is when they were talking about how sort of authoritative this is. You don't need to translate that. Anyway, okay, so let me summarize. So we have looked at three official documents. We look at, first of all, we look at the PRC one, and then the Ming history, and then the Great Ming Unification Record. Let's now do it in reverse and do the revision. What you can see is that the Ming government, they published the Great Ming Unification Record, and according to them, Thailand, Laos is inside the Ming Empire, whereas Tibet is outside the Ming Empire. The official history that was compiled by the Qing government basically agrees as the same thing. Thailand and Laos is inside, and then Tibet and Mongolia, they are outside of the Ming Empire. And the PRC position is just the opposite. In other words, this and this, they agree with each other, but this one is just opposite. The yellow means China. Okay? Anything is within yellow means China, white means outside China. Tibet, over here, is moved from this end to this end. Yeah? And Thailand and Laos is moved from here to here. So they just totally disagree with each other.
Tanda mingi gome kap ne yo dewe gi yikcha da sabda donzu si yung du any pranzo gi tanda pyo di gyami nga gong lo tsigi mewa che Thailand, chang Thailand di gyami nga gong lo tsigi yuwa che ine pyo di chige lungba che lo tsigi yuwa che ta di gi je la mingi gerab lo yu di yang ching gi gome gi kap la yang konzo gi dom goni gyab che konzo gi kwe yung du e tanda di Pöödi chi gegab kongla tsi wada Ani Thailand donzo Ani ya gyami gi mingi gomegi kongla tsi Lukso tsi wadi kunyi chikson res Iba inne gyami gi tanda di Masho gi shiong gi langzho se ne re Konzo gi sabda donzo nalo la Pöödi ming gomegab ne Gyami ming gomegi kongla inba chi chuwa re Sudu gerab Bing da ching da konzo ki gerab lo gyu ki ikcha donzo da yanda doya ki ezu shibes.
Well, I do want to emphasize once more, I mean, these two documents are well recognized and universally accepted by all Chinese, including, of course, the PLC as the most reliable and authoritative documents by the respective governments of those dynasties.
Ani, kien kwa kesh puji kabe shiwa ina, Ikja Ming gi tanda gerab lu gyu donzo Ming da Qing gi tanda ma chokdom nang sha gyo donzo ani gemi tsame gi ani kungden zi ya tana gemi ma sho shung ge kungden zi de ya gi ikja shi donzo gi cha de gyo re shi
Well, Mr. Wang Yu, I have this is now 4:50. What do you want me to do? What do you think is the best thing for me to do? What should I skip or what should I do?
Why don't we go at least another 30 minutes?
Okay.
And then we'll have questions.
Okay. Some more? Skip Lei Su. Okay, skip Lei Su. How about if I skip the encyclopedias?
Yeah.
I skip this part, okay. Do you think it's worth telling the story about the living Buddha inviting living Buddha? Do you think that story is good?
Yeah, I like it.
You like the story? Okay. Okay, now, it's, again, as I've said, when people tell stories, you can see, you know, I mean, this is like Grimm fairy tales, right? I mean, you know, Tibetan tell stories, Chinese tell stories, and then they actually, most of them lie, by the way. Okay. So, how do you know that this is real? How do you know this is valid? Well, again, it's very important. You look at the sources. Every time that people tell you what is quote-unquote a historical event, you always ask them, where does it come from? I mean, can I trust you? Now, I'm telling you this thing that is a straight translation from, again, that's the reason why I took pains to explain the system of this Chinese, what you call, you know, historical records. Okay, so this is from one of those official correct history, Ming history, and also it's recorded in the Ming veritable records. In other words, it's by Chinese standard. These are very reliable records. They don't make things up. And also, I think when you hear history, the other thing is not only you ask about the sources, but also is that, are the contents believable? Do they sound like it's, you know, it's not make up? So well, you make up your own mind with this. But this is what the Chinese have written, by the way, okay? It's not what the Tibetans or what the communists have written, it's what, you know, the people in the Ming dynasty, they wrote, okay? So anyway, this is a straight translation. So according to scroll 331, Ming history, Western lands, remember I said that Tibet was sort of covered, you know, the relationship between Tibet and China was covered in scroll number 331 of Ming history, which has a total of 332 scrolls. In other words, this is sort of the most unimportant things about China. Anyway, okay, the detail about what happened with Tibet. Okay, so it says this. Okay. Tibet, this is the Kamapa. Actually, it's a living Buddha. In Chinese, we call it Dabaofawa. Okay. So, recorded the tribute was submitted, blah, 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 and so forth. At that time, the emperor was misled by his attendants, who told him that a monk in Tibet could see through three incarnations, and it is hailed as a living Buddha by the monk's country. And actually, the word country is used explicitly. You know, it says, you know, this is a Tibet country, and there's this monk. And the emperor then wanted to meet him and ordered the eunuch Liu Yin to be the ambassador to invite the monk.
Incidentally,
I want to stress the term ambassador to invite. In other words, it specifically mentioned this, an ambassador is to invite. Now, of course, the Chinese emperors do not send ambassadors to invite you if your area is under his rule. They will just summon you. The prime minister, which is called Liang Chu, okay, objected to this. So the prime minister and others told the emperor the following. And that's, look, although the early emperors of our Ming dynasty had sent envoys there, but it's because at that time we have just conquered China, and we have done it, you know, to guide and educate the ignorant and to control the comfort of faraway places. After we have enjoyed peace, the succeeding emperors have only bestowed presents, okay, to these Tibetans because they came and seek audience with the emperor. That's the only relationship that we have with them, okay? They come and, you know, meet the emperor, we give them presents. And we have never carelessly abused our diplomats by sending them to that remote place. It's like, my goodness, this is a remote and godforsaken place. We'll never be there, okay? We're not interested in that place at all. Also, this Liu Yin, okay, the eunuch, okay, is asking for lots of resources, and we can't waste our money that way. It's going to cause hardship to our government and people. So the prime minister goes on with his objection, okay, and of course his colleagues, okay, giving all kinds of reasons why the emperor should be doing that. So there's a continuation. So he's telling the emperor, he says, Furthermore, after leaving our border at Tianchen, six barbarians. Now, this is again a standard geographic term in China, okay? Our border in central Sichuan is here, okay? So this is where Tianchen Liufan is. In other words, the Ming prime minister is telling specifically the emperor that this is our national border, okay? And after we leave our border, there is nothing else. It's beyond our power. By that time, we still have tens of thousands of miles to go before we get to Tibet. But then there's absolutely no station. We can't protect ourselves. If the raiders are encountered, how can the entourage be defended? It will lower the stature of China and invite humiliation from the barbarians because we'll be exposed to these people. Okay? The whole idea is totally unacceptable. We, your subordinates, regret that we'll not be able to perform the associated documentation work for your majesty. In other words, the prime minister is telling the emperor, if you want to do it, you do it on your own. You know, I mean, we are not going to cooperate.
Any the day time would draw in, any ones who can no choke it, and the sons of gage, any a mile dente, Tita Mangu Tadu draw where the low Mangu Korea Gilanga in the day, and the Hanashi Langa, any K, Mevache, and the Poru de Lania, the day Giania, the day Giani, Gessi, Jonge Sola, any Kanye Choma, and the Chuaina, and Lalos and the Kanye Chuaina, and the Yana Goma, the Manguchi. Much away in the time to chagre, the day he any day did. Pomego and I and Naro Namato did like a good mess to assure this.
So other people objected too, and the emperor just ignored all of them and proceeded on his own wishes.
Any innate Yana Pomego and Ponzogi Lampton Cheva de la Massene, any the Dungu Cheva this.
Okay, so the emperor started preparing, you know, to, all these gifts for this living Buddha in Tibet. So the description is quite detailed. I'm just translating some of those. Okay, string of pearls were used to make religious banners, and gold was used to make religious utensils and golden seals and so forth. It completely depleted the gold holdings of the imperial palace. This is recorded very explicitly, okay, in the histories that they use up all the gold in the palace. Okay, and then of course the tens of thousands of tiles of silver, and then thousands and hundreds of thousands units of tea and salt. And also, the emperor tells the eunuch that you get 10 years to do it. In other words, then these people have no idea how far this Tibet is, so they say, okay, you know, you have 10 years to do this.
And then the Gomengu in the Prasenta Chen, any dukes chija, any tanda di sheshu, sangye se di la, any tanda di mangu chik, any dukes chija, ya, kuya la, and Taji Nawar has been a Muti Mangbutan. Any serb Mangbu Shuch, any bad Bangzu, Halam serb Tongacha, the day Mangbuji, Prang in the Tadiche, any bad Mu, and Halam Shi, Chadan, Sada, Mangbuji, any Langa Kazu, Godro Yume, De Makedu, any Lochu of Gorne, Digi Yus Cheje, and those Cheje, any Gombashiwares.
I'm going to skip some of these details. So anyway, it caused a lot of hardship. It was a lot of resources they were dumping into it. Okay, so these are the details that I won't go into it. When Liu Yin goes from the capital city, when they reach Sichuan, they then also want the Sichuan provincial government to come up with another 200,000 tiles of silver, okay, to buy even more presents and prepare for more things. And 200,000 tiles at that time was like the entire annual budget of the Sichuan provincial government. And the local officials said, okay, let's reduce it to 130,000, which is like more than half of the annual budget. And that was to prepare more gifts. And then the workers started working, you know, for a year to do that.
And so
after having stayed in Sichuan for another year to make even more preparation, then finally they proceeded into Tibet, bringing 10 military officers and 1,000 soldiers. And incidentally, this is the only time during the entire Ming Dynasty when the Chinese Empire sent troops into Tibet. Okay, it's the only time when troops were sent into Tibet, not to have war or to battle with the Tibetans, but to invite them to bring the monk back to China. And then after 2 months, they reached the monk's region.
Any from the Sichuan Sebila, any but Lochik's Devi Jela, any from Mutun, any Mapuchus, any Mami Tongchik's Yamu, any Chibas, any Mingi, and the Gomekabla, any Pernalo, like Mingi, Mami Chiwa, and Neta Dichipo, or the Chuo, my dear Maja, and they remember Jet, and the Pane, any Pubegi, any Lama Dia, the Nishuag Chibo, any this.
So, after they have reached the monks' region, which is about 70 miles west of Lhasa today, that's where the monastery was. Now, this is a trace translation, okay? I mean, these are written by Chinese Mandarins, and they don't think very highly of the Tibetans, so, but this is a trace translation. It says, the so-called living Buddha, okay, was worried that a Chinese man harmed and hit himself. Basically, the monk says, I don't believe in these people, you know, bring so many gifts, and they say they won't invite me, I don't know what they're up to, okay? So they hit themselves, okay? This angered the Chinese military and plan to use force. They just want to kidnap the guy and bring it back to the emperor, right? The barbarians, again, this is trace translation, okay? That's what the Chinese call it, whatever. The barbarians attacked them at night, seizing all the treasures and weapons. Two officers and several hundred soldiers died, and an additional half their number was wounded. Another out of 1,000, 400 died, and the other 200 were wounded, okay, and the others was just scattered.
Any tanda pagin le biyong du, any tanda pebegi, si kunso gitsi dea di, tanda lama di, any bet, kunso gi, yami ki lukyu na lo ti yong du, any pran, shena chongje, dinde mi pyoen chenpo yende, nyambo mambo si ki yong du, any bet, pran so ti wa di la, any pran, shena chongje, kaba ta, and di jala, any yami ki, ma hong, Suraj Pujutai Gi, any Dux Chidu, any La Logi, any Batela, any Adichiris, Consula, any the Ma Dhamas, that Lalo Sidu, the Pebal who were in a any big of any Gabi Mambuchi, Mambu Mambuchi, any the Ronchi, and Mambuchi Megon Chavas.
So Liu Yin himself escaped using a fast horse, was only able to save himself and nothing else. And after reaching Chengdu, he told his subordinates not to say anything, and he used a fast horse to submit a report to Beijing, okay? But it was an empty envelope with nothing in it, because he doesn't want to say.
The front two tourists, the opposite of the stranger, in a Shibak cake of two yomaris, and Quran Chengdu said, Leb Yongdu Quran, any Quran, the Wali Yube, the Bejis, and the Quran, the Shabji Sola. And the Nezu Korla came Malabrochi and the Krangi Kata. And then any Ya Gomala Ya Nyatos Roji Ya Tangi Yue Kuchene Yigo Topaji Ya Pusha Res Kazasana Nandoyo Kariti Uyume Praha Kubmedu Yigo Topaji Ya Pusha Res.
So when the report of this eunuch reached the court, the emperor who originally sent the eunuch to Tibet, he has died, and the successor, the next emperor, was so angry that he ordered Liu Yin to be the eunuch to be brought back to the capital city and be punished for his wrong doings. The end of story. Okay. Now the anticlimax, which is an anticlimax, but the anticlimax is actually the climax for our purpose, because if you think about it, is that why punish the eunuch? The eunuch didn't do anything wrong. It was the monk and his soldiers that killed these Chinese soldiers and took away all the presents. There's no mention about condemning these monks or even saying anything bad or let alone punishing, okay? Which means that there's only one thing, that the emperor has no power over these monks, and even though these monks have killed the soldiers, there's nothing he can do about it. You have to remember that at that time, the Ming Dynasty, okay, had, in contrast, sent armies and ships, okay, as far away as Indonesia to punish people that defy his orders. Okay, so in comparison, you can see that the fact that the story ends here and there's no mention or no condemnation of the monks means something very obvious.
간다 년도 동바 디 바게 아 야나 공마 조리 운데 디디 공마 디 아 총사 요체 디게 아니 중마 디게 엔 크랑게 공마 중마 디게 아니 단다 디 딩에 구섭 아 디 아니 아 야나 수 칠로 제제 아니 크랑라 아니 아 녀와타야기 아니 까타마레스 다디 엔두 아 더 룸더 조레스 이바 있네 아니즈 게 좀에 어려워요 때 있네 내가 친구도 가르치고 어려워 있나 구섭기 너는 눈주 게 제시하는데 게 말해서 같은 수는 무의 좀 왔다 아니즈 상마디 아니 단다 아 자와서 있네 레 단다 콘저기 라로라로 세대야기 콘저기 제시하고 있는데 다 개미기 공마이기 나고라면도 아니 개미 공마라 디 왕자 개메도 아니 원에기 아니 좀 진예 돈졸라 녀와다야기 왕자 개메도 아니 아디 카페고 올라나 드디 아 나고 멤버지 된게 요래 페나 인도네시아 세롱바 인데기 가가시기 아니 카브레 자나 고마기 카단 게 로고 요와이나 아니 자나 고마기 마포 파게 바도 땅제 아니 바 녀와다야 바서 바다 아니 독스 치토고 요래
Well, what do you want me to do? Do you want me to continue or open up for Q&A?
That's a few questions if there's any questions.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for your attention. Do you have any questions for me? Yes, sir.
I'm not a judge. 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 I'm not a judge.
그 question was if at the time of the Ming and Qing dynasties if Tibet was considered a foreign a country then what was the name that was used to refer to Tibet
Okay, we actually have seen that in the map. It's called Sipan. But actually there are two names. But I mean, look at the map. Well, actually, it's right here. Sorry, it's right here. The map. That's called Sipan. Okay. But actually, there are two names, and I'll show you over here the characters. Okay, I'll show you the characters. There are two names. One is called Tubo. And one is called Sifan. And then usually the term Tubo is used to refer to what amounts to today's TAR, Tibet out of the Autonomous Region. Whereas the area east of it, which is what is in today's Qinghai, the Tibetan areas in Sichuan and Yunnan, those Tibetans they are called Sifan.
Sifan.
Right. However, there's a mix-up. Very often, sometimes, if you look at maps, I don't have time to show you. If you look at these maps, sometimes you label areas that really belong to Sifan as Tubo and vice versa. Mm-hmm. For the simple reason is that, honestly, if you look at those documents, it becomes very obvious that the Chinese couldn't care less who these people are, okay? So that's the reason why it's very often mislabeled. Are you following me?
Or? Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay, it's right here.
Yeah.
And Tubo and
Hello, Pujutang de Tanya ni tubers said the Sifan said ni yores. One is here in a tubers said the any Puran Jonjon of Pogwa, the Sifan said the any Puran Jonjon, the Shadley, such a Sagun of Pogu yore there. Sometimes the Siwa in a Gabriel doesn't need to say Pujutangwagi, the Nedam of Yore de D. Halton Gores, Nagami, the Ding Kawashida, Mewada, Chigga Brangi Tony, Sisu.
So in fact, as an example, if you look at a map, they only use the term Sifan to label everything that is just west of their boundary, and they don't even bother to identify, you know, the next area, which is Tubo.
Sometimes I know the concept of Sifan. I mean, Yachimuroji, Kowaroji, Mato, any Tubo said it means the position that Tangi Meleji, Mapuji Ores.
Not too much here, though. 하나 그게 아니 이게 그게 야궁이 내가다 그 꽃이라 뭐지 아니 이게 뭐 어쩌나 좀 이제도 처음 뭐 없긴 되고 심죽세네 맞아도다 카가리에서 나오러 와 근데 다들 그 뒤 라비에디 맞아 그 구지 체조래 그러나 정나타는 말도 지내려고 그래 양 아주 기 라브로 치는 구지신 에네데 라교래 어디 다 저와 관계 그게 나나 지기도 그나
So you explained and went into great lengths to explain to us using the official records that Tibet was not a part of China according to the official records. And what prompted you, what motivated you to begin this and to share this with us?
Well, I'm not sure that's it, but well, I can talk about it after the lecture, but this is very personal. But yeah, I'll be happy to answer your question, but maybe we can do it later on. We are running out of time. Let's talk about something about Tibet, rather than something about me.
He wants to know if he was prompted to come and speak today by the who organized it. I think he wants to know that.
U.S. Select Committee.
Did you say the U.S. Tibet Committee did?
Okay. Now, in that case, I think I do want to address this. This is a very important question. But it's a Do you understand English?
What motivated you to share this with us? And are you doing this on a voluntary?
I need to answer. It's still going to be very short, by the way. I can't answer the great details, but I'll answer it short.
ta kona tanga tonen na mina ko chaba jabe dare we 영미는 케원이라고
그래. 케원, 프로페서.
연하게 계란 냄새 바래.
그런
일이 있냐?
아, direct translation, right? So you could respond when you undertook to do this research, were you asked by an organization or any persons to do this research, or is it something you volunteered and did on your own? That was the question.
That was it? I mean, there were a lot of questions.
That was just
finally.
That was it. Oh, okay. Okay. I'll do a short version, and I'll do a short version. I'll be happy to give you a long version after this whole thing is over. Okay. I don't want to tell my life story, you know. but as you can see, I'm a Chinese. Okay. I was not born in China. I don't hold a Chinese passport, but I am culturally speaking a Chinese. Okay. At home I talk to my wife. Okay. Only in Chinese. I spent most of my time reading Chinese books. Okay. When I was in high school, I was interested in Chinese geography and Chinese history and Chinese literature. But I couldn't major in Chinese literature and history because at that time, doing that, it would be difficult to make a living. So I studied engineering for my undergraduate degree, and my PhD was in business, and after that I became a business professor. So my wife also became a business professor in the United States. I'll stop. Sorry, go ahead.
나라 예민이시네 예민이 근데 이게 단다디 파스포트 MS 이봐 있네 나 단다 취주갑네 아니 로센 논조 망고 로센 셴바도 토나 요아치나 당부 결합 루규다 인데 라 로촌 자이기 토나다 이 요에네 투두 아니 디 자이기 고가베도 총마송스 엔 디젤 단다 나랑네 아니 단다디 엔지니어링 다인데 제제 아니 로촌 자한제 단다
So I've been a business professor in the United States and in Hong Kong all these years. I retired five years ago, and I could afford to go back to my favorite subject, which is Chinese history and literature. And at that time, I was not doing just Tibet history. I was basically doing Chinese history. And then when I started reading the Chinese historical documents, then I realized, hey, wait a minute, no, this is something that's really interesting. And also I found out that basically the PRC has been just, pardon me, lying, okay? I mean, just outright lies. They distorted Chinese history. And so by that time, I decided to concentrate on this because the more I dig up, the more I find it fascinating.
I love you. 링을 두저 다니 마셔와 제 이내 제라 개인 슈웨기 제라 안 두저 유두 아니 나기 토나 유데기 결합 루규 돈소 아니 아 로야다 토나 제기 두저 라두 아니 아 얘기 가즈 마마 때두 아니 개미기 아니 베기 루규 돈소 라 주시에 와다 데 망부지 토나 용도 가즈 마마 때와 이내 젠제 이내즈 망부 슈치 엔 도스네기 심주 제 용도 데 통소
오케이 And then after that, I decided to share my findings. So for example, last year in the International Tibetans Conference is organized by Dalai Lama's organization in Brussels. I was invited to give a speech. In another one that was organized by the government in exile in Taiwan, they organized a conference. Again, I was invited to give a speech there. I was sort of a major speaker in those conferences. And of course, among other invitations, is the invitation by the U.S. Committee. Now, pardon me for saying this, since it was a question about this, I need to put it very bluntly. In all of these cases, the invitation always comes with an offer to pay for all my transportation, my hotel bills, and in every case, I have turned down the offer. I pay for my entire airfare, I pay for all my hotel bills, and everything else. And that was true in the trip to Brussels. It was true in the trip to to the trip to Taiwan, and part of people saying this, this time the same thing, they have been very kind in the invitation that to offer me to pay for my airfare, my hotel. We are not accepting it, we are paying for all these expenses. The reason is that I'm a Chinese. If any Chinese were to find out that I'm accepting money from the Tibetans for saying something like this, my name will be dragged through mud by the Chinese. But right now I can say that I'm not accepting a single cent from the Tibetans or from anybody else, okay? I'm just sharing my interest. This is what I found out. So that answers the
question. Vishungi goji now egi tondu Brussels the Yuata Tan and she heaven gi any Vishungi Busa Puganda Manguchi gi su ade Narak Ketanje Digala any Kameshuegi the Dig Kugapta Manguchi Dinja Manguchi Nansus the Digi any Yine Garaj Nuene Kawaki Shaka Chimba Yine Dende Shunge Sogi any goji now do. Any Jordan la sopa any chik joson ma po chik mu na chik na gi den de kamen na gi yoe ni gi mu chik e leng gi mes ka chen shi wa ina mu le ba ina han dang ye a ngue ne ta ge si a dan dang ngue ne su khari ba di she de he shi mo si we thon ne ta ge si ge mi ngue ne any ye gi ke ja de she la Jordan ne re khari ba ne le ba den de gi ne su chi cha gi yoe ina any ngara minje sharo de ma to ye mi gi ku no di any ngwe ne su di any she ya sam yins
I have something to add which has nothing to do with Tibet, okay? I see a lot of young people over here, but just remember, work hard, and when you get old, retire, you save enough money, you can do whatever you want, okay? And you don't have to give a damn about anybody else.
Professor, are you going to bring your wonderful work into a book form?
Well, actually, what I have presented is like 1% of the material that I have, which I'm writing a book and I hope I'll be able to finish it before I die, because actually, since 5 years ago, when people ask me, I tell them that I'll finish it next year, and I've been doing it for the last five years. Every year, I'll say I'll try to finish it next year. So I'll try to finish it before I die, but we'll see.
Okay, I hope you will finish very soon.
I hope so too.
Okay, and are you anticipating any objections from the government of China because of what you have mentioned before?
I just told you, I'm okay. Retired. I live in the United States. I can afford to tell people to pardon me, go to hell.
No, there's really something else.
I think that there's so much misunderstanding between the Chinese and the Japanese, and between the Chinese and the Americans. And I think the same thing with the Chinese and the Tibetans. Okay, and that's not all Chinese are crooked. Yeah, that's basically it.
Next.
He wanted to thank you
for
the valuable work that you've done, and you know, for taking such initiative and doing the work that you've done, and also he's requesting and urging you to take good care of your health and to take care in general.
Yeah. Well, actually, Thank you very much for your support and for your time, and it's too bad that I couldn't present more of the material. I hope one day I'll have a chance to present this to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Mrs. Lau, may I present you with
my wife, Amy, with a student of the sport, also with the leading
group. Angela, thank you very much. Angela, here.
Morning, thank you, because you were able to show that Tibet was not a part of China, and this is something that we as Tibetans are personally responsible for knowing, and we are very grateful and thankful that you undertook this, and we are very grateful for what you have done.
Well, thank you very much. It's my pleasure. Thank you.
I am the president of the Tibetan National Congress, and as a token of our appreciation for your work, we would like to present you with a compilation of everything that's up there, that's made into a calendar. We would like to present that to you, because this is also a collection of proof as to Tibet's independence from China.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.